32. Ino plots against Phrixus. Once upon a time, Athamas, son of Aeolus and Enerite, ruled Boeotia. To obey Hera's command, Athamas married divine Nephel, and begot a son Phrixus and a daughter Hel. But Athamas loved the mortal Ino, daughter of Cadmus and Harmonia. So, he married again, brought Ino, as his second wife, and begot two sons, Lyrcus and Melisertes. Nephel sorrowfully found Athamas loved Ino more than her. With hurt and anger, the divine Nephel left Athamas and returned to the gods. Ino hated the children of Nephel, and with Nephel gone, she plotted against Nephel's son Phrixus. She persuaded the women of her tribe, without the knowledge of their men, to parch the seed grains and thereby make them infertile. Secretly, the women parched the seed grains. Unaware, the men sowed the parched seeds and the earth did not yield any crops. Athamas was worried that a famine may occur, and he sent messengers to the oracles at Delphi to inquire how the dearth may end. But Ino bribed the messengers to say that, if Phrixus, the son of Nephel, was sacrificed to Zeus, then the infertility would end and crops would grow again. The citizens demanded the sacrifice of Phrixus, and reluctantly, Athamas agreed. But Nephel rescued her children Phrixus and Hel, by sending a ram with golden fleece, which she had received from Hermes. Sitting on this ram, Phrixus and Hel escaped through the sky. While crossing the sea between Sigeum and Chersonese, Hel accidentally slipped off the ram, fell in the sea, and drowned. The sea was called as Hellespont after her. Phrixus arrived to Colchis and was greeted by Aeetes, the king of Colchis. Aeetes gave his daughter Chalciope in marriage to Phrixus. Phrixus sacrificed the ram to Zeus and gave the golden fleece to Aeetes, who in a grove of bears, nailed it to a big oak tree. Phrixus and Chalciope had children named Argus, Melus, Phronus, and Sidosaurus.